YouTube.com/TimWestwoodTV. Yo, Tim Westwood TV up at the spot. Legendary Crib Session just went in with a freestyle. Shout out to my man Hopsin, Dizzy, Jarren up in here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean, fam?
Yeah, thanks for having us, man. We appreciate it. Yeah, yeah.
Came straight from the airport.
Yeah, straight from the airport. Tired as hell, but
yeah, exactly.
Still
did you?
Do it.
And a little European tour situation?
We were in Iceland yesterday.
Crazy.
We had two shows last night.
Crazy.
So now we out here and...
About to do you, baby.
Yeah, yeah. So it's going to be crazy to see the fan reactions out
exactly.
here.
Exactly. A lot of people really, you know, looking forward to tonight's show. You know, you're going to go in and handle it.
Yeah, they've been waiting for years and we're finally out here, son.
Yeah, man. I mean, the buzz is intense. Mm-hmm. I mean, your YouTube situation, mad.
Yeah, yeah.
Numbers beyond belief.
Yeah, niggas got bars, you know what I'm saying? Niggas be going in on niggas, you know what I'm saying, son?
Going in. Now, that is what you specialize in, is going in, leaning on the neck till the vein stands out hard.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Going in, leaning on the neck till the vein stands out hard.
Exactly.
Straight from Tim Westwood
himself.
I'm
standing on your head right now, kid.
Standing on your head.
Exactly. Your eyes are popping and rolling to the back of the dome.
Yes.
What's happening out there, MCs?
What's happening, son? What's happening?
I mean, you know, you specialize in killing MCs. Any cats you really gunning for at the moment?
I don't know. I still debate whether or not I should just smash the hell out of Soulja Boy in his whole career, because he did some little stupid crap. And
What happened?
No, it was on Tiny Chat. I was doing a webcam thing, and he hopped on and started talking crap. So I've been debating. I don't know if he made some little diss to me or not. It was whack if it was a diss. It was horrible. But yeah,
so
but
he jumped on the webcam.
Yeah, yeah. He was talking crap. I had left when he got on, and then. So he was talking all this crap, and then as soon as I got in, he started smiling, and he wasn't saying nothing. But it's all online bullshit. It's not even, like, that serious. But it's just funny. But then he made a song, like, a week later, but it didn't say my name in it, but it was on Worldstar and all these other sites as a Hopsin diss, and he also posted as, like, some Hopsin diss, so I was like, okay. But he's not a real MC, though, so it's like trying to take candy from a baby, just beating up a little preschooler. So I don't know if it would be funny to do it, just for entertainment purposes, but I don't know if it's...
So you would say Soulja Boy's on the to-do list, but not at the top?
Yeah, he's definitely on the list, but he's so far at the bottom, I may just...
Okay, you might not get to him.
Yeah.
Who is above?
Yeah.
Who's your top three on the to-do list when it comes to smashing MCs?
Well, I've said everything I had to say about the rappers that I dislike, so there's not really anybody right now that I really dislike, you know, that I haven't already talked about in past songs.
Okay,
I don't know about these guys, but...
But 2013, new beef, new drama.
I don't just go looking for it. That's not what I'm, like, fully about. I mean, if something comes up, then it is what it is. But as of right now, there's nothing on the plate.
Okay. There's no beef on the plate, baby.
No.
Keeping vegetarian for a hot minute.
Yeah.
Now, Ill Mind of Hopsin 5, crazy numbers. Yo, nearly hitting 20 mil, baby.
Yeah, it's crazy. I didn't expect it to get that much love at all. I was thinking, like, by now I'd only have like 2 or 3 million views,
yeah,
and the shit just took off.
Yeah,
definitely blessed.
So the momentum is there, man.
Yeah, and you know, I just wanted to talk to the younger generation and just keep it real with them and make them look at their lives and go, what the hell am I doing? So I'm glad it's actually working. People are coming up to me at my shows, telling me that it changed their lives and all that. So it's really cool.
So what exactly are you saying, you know, to these young folks coming up? What are you saying?
Well, it's just be, like, productive. That's the main thing. Just be productive. Don't throw your life away. Like, don't make your existence just worthless. And to where you get 80 years old and you're like, damn, I didn't really accomplish anything on my goal list. Didn't even have a goal list because I was too lazy to make one. Like, I think it's cool to just look back at your life and be like, dang, I did that. And you feel a lot better about yourself as well. It boosts up your confidence. You can smile more, you know. So people who don't accomplish goals, they always knocking other people down, and they're always just, man, it's just on some bullshit. So I just wanted to give them, you know, a jolt of that positive energy, you know, that I have. So
it was
in an aggressive way.
Yes,
but I felt it had to be that way.
Yeah, sometimes you have to wake people up, man.
Yeah.
So you know, to motivate people, what would you recommend they do, man? like a goal list is strong. A goal list.
Make a goal list and don't just because somebody else says
that goal list. What was that like? Smash hot bitches. That would be number one on my list. Is that motivational?
If that's every morning,
motivational kids.
Realistic basic goals.
Smash busted bitches.
Smash busted
bitches left over from Hopsin security.
All right, if that's on your goal list, I hope you accomplish it. You need to work towards doing that every
maybe
day.
Maybe hit the gym. Maybe hit the gym.
Be that guy who pulls up and really does it. Go hard on it.
Not models, ex-models, failed models.
Just go hard on it.
Tattoos, stretch marks, and scars, all accepted.
Yeah. Hit the gym. I need to hit the gym myself.
Okay, so what is a motivational list, brother? What would be on there for a young and coming up to get him like amped up to do something with his life as opposed to just it pass by?
Well, different people live different lives, yes, which means they have different goals. Yeah. Like my personal goal is, I've been skateboarding for 15 years, but I never really went hard on it. So on my goal list, I have to hit a handrail before I die.
Okay.
And I've never hit a handrail ever in my whole entire life.
So stop playing with that.
Yeah,
I'm going to. Stop coasting. Stop coasting, fam.
Yeah.
Hit the handrail and bust some bones.
Yeah. and there's something else on my goal list is I want to have a movie. I want to make a movie. I don't know what it's going to be about.
You
want to
make a
movie? Yeah, I want to
make
a movie.
Jarren.
You want to make a movie like a proper movie?
Oh yeah, an actual real movie, a real
so you
movie.
Want to be in a movie? So
but I have to be the star of it though.
Hell yes.
Yeah. I want to be. Well, I'm never gonna sign a deal, but I want to be so big independently.
Yes.
Towards just like I'm Justin Bieber status, but I never had the deal, and I'm just never not even the same.
Yeah.
Not even the same outlets, but it's just like when I step outside, it's like But that would be cool.
Okay.
But then again, that also has a bad side. But it is kind of on my goal list.
Well, I've got something similar like that.
What's yours?
I've always wanted a Justin Bieber blowout. I've always wanted that. You know, to do that thing he does with the hairdryer. I've always wanted that.
I can't do that shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't have the kind of hair that you
okay,
have.
Okay. So those are now.
But some people may want to. I don't know. Everybody, what's on your goal list?
Exactly.
Dizzy Wright. Show us.
Yo, I am a daddy. So I just want to be the best daddy that I could be, you know, do this rap shit, smoke weed, you know, travel the world, kick it with the homies, and just be a good daddy. That's it.
Okay, a good daddy.
That's my only goal.
To a daughter or a son?
You ain't trying to rap,
I got a
son?
Daughter.
Okay. Don't you rap, nigga? What, you just on a label, nigga? And you just going to be him, nigga?
Nigga?
You just going to be
rap,
him, nigga?
Nigga.
No, just messing with it.
Okay, so number one baby father in the building.
Yes.
Respect that. Respect the baby daddy. You know what I mean?
Number one.
A father to the daughter, baby.
Jarren Benton, what's on your goal list? Yes.
You know, since he
to
said
get
that
twisted
shit.
In the morning, baby. What time is it?
I don't even know.
3 a.m, baby. So it's like, what time is it back home for you?
And
like
I'm
7
twisted.
In the morning.
It's like 7, yeah, you know,
yeah. Yeah, getting straight twisted on the Ciroc.
I just want to be able to be. To be able to also be in a position where my kids don't worry about shit, but also teach them the morals of what it means to struggle and what it means to put forth that effort to get where the fuck you want to be. Also, my goal is to do a couple more shots with fucking Tim Westwood.
Yeah, fucking A. To get twisted toe up, baby.
Yeah.
Now, you as a baby father, how many little picnics you got?
I got two, man.
Oh, man, knocking them out, kid.
A couple of other ones I don't even know about. Same baby mama.
Okay.
Yep, not a statistic. Same baby mama.
Same baby mama and in different tour cities.
The same city. She been rocking with me for a minute.
Okay.
Got a couple of throat babies, but you know.
Oh yeah, baby.
Dang. You guys are wild.
Yeah, yeah. You'll be coughing up your babies. Now we are going in. Independent kid. Fiercely independent.
Yes.
Working, happening out there, making it work.
Yeah. Living the dream.
Exactly.
Come to life.
Signing to Ruthless, I mean.
Horrible mistake.
Horrible.
But I benefited from it. I learned a lot.
Exactly. And also, you know, Eazy-E, you know, was a legendary moment, you know. So I can understand how you made that mistake.
Ice Cube felt the same way at one point in time, too.
Ice Cube. Yeah, I
by
know
the way.
Yeah.
Bone Thugs.
Bone Thugs and Harmony felt the same way.
Tamika Lane is just a fuck up.
Yeah.
By the way,
even if Eazy-E, rest in peace, if he was alive, I think he'd feel the same way as well.
I don't want to condone any of the stuff Hopsin talking. If you ever see me and you want to give me a sloppy toppy, I'm all for it.
Oh, he's sloppy is his middle name, baby.
Sloppy.
Yeah, sloppy. Darren Sloppy Boy. Now, we are going in there. Now, first things first, what is the situation with the releases coming up? 2013 going to be a big movie.
Okay.
A big year, baby.
Okay. This is what's going down for me. Well, the Funk Volume 2012 tour is going on.
Funk
right
Volume
now.
Strong.
It ends like in late November, which is in a few weeks. Then after that, take a little break.
So that's the Funk Volume. That's the end of the Funk Volume.
Yeah, that's the end of the Funk Volume tour.
Okay,
for 2012.
Done.
Yeah, so we all going to be working on music. I'm in the process of working on my Knock Madness album. When is it going to come out? I don't fucking know, bro. I just talk it, dude. I don't fucking know. It may never drop.
But when is it coming out?
Who knows? Who knows?
But I need to know.
Yeah, yeah. So this is like the junior detox right here.
Okay,
so
okay.
Yeah, I'm actually waiting for Dre to drop his.
Oh, fucking
so
A.
Then, yeah, so exactly. Then I can listen to it, study it, and try to make mine.
Exactly.
Copy.
Yeah, hold your breath. It's coming soon.
Yeah. Yes. Nah, but yeah, I'm working on Knock Madness. And aside from that, I'm also working with Travis Barker. We're going to get in the studio when I get back to Los Angeles. And we're going to just work on some tracks and all that and just... Yeah, just try to come up with something funky.
Okay.
Izzy, what you got?
2013, I'm just going to keep working, man. Dropping a project December 3rd called The First Agreement. It's an EP. It's just like my end of the year package. You know, I've been going strong all year. So I just want to stay consistent next year. So, I mean, I'm just going to keep going. Whatever. I make a lot of music. I'm always in the studio, always working. So, you know, I'm not holding back from anything. I'm just going to work, you know, so... That's my plan for next year.
Still riding bareback?
What's
this guy be clowning. This guy be clowning.
Me, I'm working on my first Funk Volume project.
Strong.
I just fucking got back. I went to Atlanta for 4 days.
Yes.
Hooked up with my nigga Kato.
Okay,
Kato. We got some monster shit. My nigga Spitzwell got some monster shit. Rockin' Man got some monster shit. Also got a project coming out with Tom York.
Oh, for
you
real?
You didn't know that, did you, motherfuckers?
Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Tom York. That's my dude.
You didn't know that.
I don't even know I got a project coming out with him. But
Tom York doesn't even know he's got a project coming out
he
with
don't,
him.
He don't, but fuck it. We got one coming.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah. More shots.
Tim Westwood working on an EP too, man.
Exactly.
Y'all didn't know Tim got skills. Kick that shit, Tim.
He got bars.
I've got bars. He's breakdancing.
Dude, I break dance. Hey, Tim, if I break dance, you got to spit some.
Spit a good 8 bars. He actually breaks stuff when he dances, though.
Oh,
he breaks his bones.
I might fuck this whole studio up.
Oh, fucking A.
Will.
Okay. Tim Westwood TV.
Can I do one of those?
Oh, yeah, please. I'd love you to.
Tim Westwood TV.
Tim Westwood. Anybody ever told you you look like a younger version of David Byrne?
No, they said he looks like the older version of Tim Westwood. Tim Westwood TV!
Tim Westwood TV! Tim Westwood TV!
Tim Westwood TV!
Yo, man, all right, it's time.
Tim Westwood TV!
Hey, Hopsin.
Tim Westwood TV!
Oh, we appreciate all the
Tim Westwood TV! And I want to thank you very much for Tim Westwood TV!
Yeah.
You got any more of this vodka? Tim Westwood TV!
So I appreciate you coming in and enjoying the Tim Westwood TV! Nothing's coming! Tim Westwood TV!
Yeah. The whole time that I'm going to be out here, I'm going to talk like this, just so you know.
Oh, I would.
As if I was from here rapping. Like, Jarren, I already told you, you look like it.
How would you just sag my pants?
Sag my pants. Look. Alright, check me out. Look. Sag my pants. Look. It's like this. I rock like a bomb. So give up the baton. I slap you after busting a fucking nut in my palm. Why you mugging me like something was wrong? Second nut in my palm. Sag fake bitch. So you can't stop me because I'm brainwashed teens and create false dreams because it pays off clean. I'm just New York. Erotic. It's one of the talk about the strange business is all screwed up. I haven't fair rap because all you suck. I sit with weak snakes and out of my pedigree because I'm too stern as hard as the name will ever be. I'm judged by my wild image a lot. And everybody seems to think I have a sense to plot. Dude. Be offended by every sentence I drop. I got some militant thoughts. And you ain't killing them off. Listen, I sag my pants until my ass shows. I even slap hoes. Yeah, I'm an asshole. Yeah, yeah. Your parents hate me because I love you. Tell them I said fuck. We gotta go. All right. Tim Westwood TV. I'm out of here. YouTube.com/TimWestwoodTV.
We're never gonna stop.
Fuck, that's good. It's addicting. We have to stop. All right, let's go. We have-